Hi everyone, this is Eric Scott and welcome to another Foodie Friday. You know, I love salmon. It's one of our favorite dishes. We eat it all the time in this house. But you know, if you're making it the same way over and over again, it quickly becomes a tired old dish. I'm going to show you a new way to make salmon. The secret ingredient is fresh sage. As always, we have Henry, our sous chef, standing by to help us out. Henry, come up and say hello to everybody. Everything in our kitchen is lab tasted and lab approved, and this lab is the best taster in the business. Sage rubbed salmon. Let me show you how it's made. Now, when I went to the market today to buy our salmon, they didn't have any fresh salmon. All they had was previously frozen or frozen salmon. If you have a choice between the two, buy the frozen salmon. These are our fillets, and I've thawed them out myself. They'll taste better if you do it that way. But one of the biggest complaints I often hear is, I don't like any frozen fish. It tastes too fishy. Let me show you a trick to prevent your frozen fish from tasting too fishy. Here's our thawed salmon fillet. The reason frozen fish tends to taste fishy is because there's a lot of fish water in it. Think of the water that's in a tuna fish can. You drain it, you don't want that in your tuna salad, and you don't want fish water in your fish fillet before you cook it. Essentially, what happens is it winds up steaming in that fish water, and your fish tastes fishy. Take a paper towel and just gently squeeze your fillet once it's been thawed and pull a lot of that moisture out. This is not going to dry your fish out. You're just taking the excess moisture out and leaving the fillet the way it was. Now, to make the sage rub for the salmon, take some fresh sage and pinch off a few leaves. You can already smell how delicious this sage is. And when you chop your herbs, roll them up in a tight little ball like this. And then let the weight of the knife actually work for you, so that when you make that first coarse cut, now you can chop the rest of your herbs and just keep moving them back and forth until they're all chopped and fine like this. We're going to take the sage and put that into a little bowl. Into that, we're going to add a teaspoon of onion powder, a teaspoon of garlic powder, and a teaspoon of fresh ground pepper. Add a little bit of olive oil, enough that you want to be able to make a paste, but you don't want it to be watery. Mix all of that in there, and as you've chopped this sage, you're releasing all of the essential oils that are in the sage, and that will aid with the olive oil in giving you a really nice sear on that fish. We're going to add a little bit of lemon. When you're trying to squeeze a lemon into a dish and you don't want to get seeds in there, cut the lemon on the side like this so that you don't get a seed, and now you can just squeeze. Here are our salmon fillets, and we're going to start with the skin side up. Take a very sharp knife and just score the salmon through the skin, not really into the flesh, but you just want to score the skin a little bit. It'll make the skin easier to take off, and it'll also give you a spot to put a little bit more flavor. Add a little generous salt and pepper. And then take our rub and just start to rub that on the back of the salmon. And make sure where you cut those slits, get a little bit of that rub in there as well. And that will bring the flavor all the way through your salmon as you're cooking it. And be generous with the rub. This is going to blacken and crisp up very nicely. Anywhere you've got the salmon, put some on the sides. And now we're ready to take them to the pan. Okay, we're ready to cook our salmon. We're going to add a little bit of oil into a hot cast iron pan that is on medium high. And we're going to put the fillets in flesh side down and let them cook for about 2 minutes on this side. We're going to flip them over. And you can see we're getting a nice crisp and sear on that salmon. We're going to finish them with a little bit of a lemon squeeze while they're still in the pan. They are ready to come out. Here are our sage-rubbed salmon fillets, and I'm going to plate them just on a bed of lettuce with a little bit of sage as a garnish for each one. So here is our sage-rubbed salmon. Mmm, delicious. No fishy flavor to it at all. Perfect texture. You wouldn't even know that it was frozen. And of course, our last step is everything has to be sent to the lab for testing. This is our lab, Henry. Come on, Henry. Let's taste. What do you think? What do you think? Was it good? Henry gives it his seal of approval. Lab tasted, lab approved, sage rubbed salmon. Thank you for watching. Follow me on Instagram at ericscott101 and on Facebook at Wine and Dine with Eric Scott for details on how you can join me this coming November for a great wine and dine cruise out of New Orleans.